Silence. How sublime and soothing it is. Long, long, long ago, there was nothing. Nothing except silence. It was then Prajapati Brahma was awarded the Brahmanda. We mortal beings call it the universe. The sound, that is Shabda, was the only possession of Prajapati Brahma. He emitted the Shabda and it pervaded the whole universe. Shabda is the life force of the whole creation and it is the force behind all activities. From the time immemorial, various Shabda has been intervened in various aspects of our life. Living without Shabda is next to impossible. Ancient music instruments produced Shabda, known to the soul, and Shabda leads us to the higher consciousness, to peace, to Samadhi. Samadhi is said to be the fourth consciousness. It is beyond the state of waking, dreaming, and dreamless sleep. The word Samadhi first appeared in the Hindu scriptures in the Maitreyi Upanishad. The diverse techniques of yoga were systematized in Patanjali's Yoga Sutras. It says, the goal of yoga is to restrain all mental fluctuations completely so as to bring about the state of Samadhi.
उत्थित ध्यान मुद्रा एंड ध्यानो एट द सहस्रार
Yoga techniques are practiced through various yogic postures to awaken the vital six spiritual centers in the body. Kundalini, the spiritual energy, dwells in Muladhara. A man's spiritual consciousness is not awakened unless his Kundalini is aroused. Along with Susamna nerve, it passes through spiritual centers, that is, Muladhar, Swadhisthana, Manipur, Anahat, Vishuddha, Agya, and at last it reaches Sahasrara center in head. And Samadhi is attained. Samadhi awards realization of the truth and ananda, the spiritual bliss. Hundred and 25 miles away from the Bay of Bengal, on the holy confluence of River Tel Nadi and Mahanadi, it is Suvarnapur, a tiny town with a prehistoric heritage. According to renowned historian Dr. Navin Kumar Shahu and archaeologist H.R. Sankhalia, Suvarnapur was the golden Lanka, the capital of legendary demon king Ravan and goddess Lankeshwari, the savior of Lanka, is worshipped even nowadays. Suvarnapur has been an acclaimed altar for Jantra, Mantra and Tantra. Famous Tantrics Madana Maluni and Sapta Kumari belongs to this land. Everything was possible here through Tantra. Human sacrifice, transformation of body from one form to another and transmigration of soul was a usual phenomenon here. The goddess is offered a lamb. She denies the offer as it has been beaten by a dog. The goddess expresses her disgust through this lady and asks for a compensation during the coming festival. They pray for forgiveness and the goddess accepts the offer. Age-old cultures and tradition are absorbed in various functions and festivals. Shakti Upasana, that is worship of the goddess, is prevalent widely in Suvarnapur. Maheshwari Yatra, Sureshwari Yatra, Samleshwari Yatra and Bali Yatra are very popular among the people. On the arrival of the month of Ashwina in the Hindu almanac, that is in October, from Mahalaya to Purnima for 15 days, the divine sound of ghanta, dhol, conch and mahuri creates a heavenly atmosphere. The saffron cloths of the priest Barwas Jargharyas, Malliks and Kshatriyas enhanced its splendor. Sacred tantric symbols known as Jantras are created to evoke spiritual energy in the Barua. In the beginning, the music instruments that serve as Shabda Brahma are worshipped. The cloth that the Barua wears during the process is first offered to the goddess. The person on whom the goddess is invoked is called Barua. By Shabda Brahma, the Barua is taken to the stage of Samadhi. While entering Samadhi, Spandan or vibration is seen in his body. After initiation into Samadhi, the Sahasrara center of the Barua is symbolically tied with leaves and flowers, popularly called as Chula Bandha. Then he is smeared with vermilion, offered garland and treated as goddess herself. All the nearby villagers come to pray the goddess. The goddess is worshipped in different places throughout the entire procession. The energy inflow heats up the Barua's body. Curd is smeared on the body of the Barua to relieve him from the ensuing heat. The two pillars are known as Jura Khamb. On arriving this place, the power of the goddess is released from the body of the Barua. The Chargharyas massage the body of the Barua to bring him back to consciousness. It is said that when mind stays in one thought for 12 seconds, it is called concentration. When it continues for 2 minutes and 24 seconds, it is called dhyana or absorption. And when dhyana continues for 28 minutes and 48 seconds, it becomes lower samadhi. A layman can attain the state of samadhi and experience its manifestations. Bali Yatra or the festival of sacrifice proves to be an example. Ancient music instruments are used as Shabda Brahma. This has a direct impact on the sound vibration within the mind of the Barua.
Samadhi, the eighth stage of Raja Yoga, manifests itself in eight manners. Spandana, Ghurni, Udbhava, Ananda, Nidra, Murcha, Jagruti. Spandana is tremor. When the energy enters into your body, then the body shakes It is said that when Kundalini is awakened, it goes up like a cobra with the sound. Pandana also manifests itself in 10 nadas. Kini, Kinkini, Tantri, Venu, Kantha, Sankha, Turi, Tala, Mrudanga, Vajra. Nada. Kini is Gini sound, tintinnabulation. Ghunguru, that is Kinkini. Then Tantri, string sound. Venu nada. Kantha nada. Vocal. Hari Om, Hari Om, Hari Om, Hari Om. Kankha nada, kanch sound. Then Vajra, there will be change of the mind, or there could be sound like. Samadhi or supramind manifests itself, it can also be after say Vandana, Ghurni or gyration. One could be acting like this, he is not under his control, but he knows what he is doing. This is, it could be like counting the beats, it could go like this, Ghurni action. Around the sun, goodly like this also. Then there is Udbhava, that is levitation. The sadhaka could be doing this. Ha! आनंद इज इलेशन. Then nidra, drowsing. Then the mind is becoming less active. Sleep will come to him. But this sleep is only yoga nidra, not sound sleep. This is sleep which a man knows. And in murcha, that is swooning, a man loses his sense. When a man thinks of talking something, but he talks or does something else, here also the mind is in a state of murcha. A fool goes to sound sleep and returns a fool. A fool goes to samadhi and returns a sage. So after each nibbikalpa samadhi or murcha, when a man comes up, he becomes a higher man. And the aim of man is to go beyond his mind and transcend itself. And this is how a man evolves from lower awareness to higher awareness.
The Barwas belong to Thanapati caste and resides in Sakama village of Suvarnapur. In order to attain samadhi, the Barwas practices Ashtanga Yoga of Patanjali. They lead an astar disciplined household life like the age-old ancient sages. We never eat any food cooked by our neighbors or relatives. We avoid to touch anybody throughout our life. We believe in non-violence and abstain ourselves from any extramarital affairs.